Hi, engineers. Today we'll be testing the RooCode AI agent using multiple MCP tools without any human interaction. The battle will be between Claude 3.5 Sonnet, Gemini 2 Flash and its thinking version, and DeepSeek R1. The task is for each large language model to use MCP tools to search the internet for the latest large language model prices, then scrape the websites, check two more sites for leaderboards, then consolidate all the information into a well-formatted table. If you already know RooCode, I added chapters so you can skip this section. RooCode is a Visual Studio Code extension. It's a fork of Cline, which was previously called Claude Dev. The main reason Roo exists is to merge more pull requests, even if they're a bit unstable, because Cline takes the stable approach. One of the main developers of Roo published a table showing the main differences between RooCode and Cline. According to me, what makes RooCode better is that it's extremely customizable. You can edit the system prompts however you wish and add new modes. Plus, it's more agentic than Cline and Aider. You can add a new mode like a specialist .NET developer and give it a specific role definition instead of the default Superman full stack developer role. You can then give it custom instructions so you don't have to move around AI rules files. The role and model selections are also very convenient. Let's show an example of creating a custom model profile. You click on the model picker and select Edit. Add a new profile and give it a logical name. Assign an API provider to the profile and enter the API key. After you select the model, you have a number of configuration options. You can explicitly set the temperature to use, tell it which agentic features to automatically approve, and provide a whitelist of safe terminal commands to execute. You can also set the execution delay between API calls to avoid rate limits. This is useful for Google Gemini experimental models. You can also limit the number of lines of the terminal output that is added to the context. This saves a lot of tokens and money. Limiting the number of open tabs to be considered for the context also saves tokens. There's a checkpoints experimental feature that I don't like in its current state. It basically creates a Git branch after every piece of work done. I like Aider's version, which names commits logically and doesn't spam create branches. RooCode also has a great model control protocol integration. It uses the standard JSON format that we expect any client to use, except Cursor, of course. If you view the MCP server's repo, you'll see that there's a Puppeteer server. Puppeteer takes in a URL as an argument and scrapes the website in question for data. Let me remove the existing global installation I have of the Puppeteer MCP so I can show how to install it. Use npm install, the MCP server package and server name along with the G flag. This will install the server in the app data directory or equivalent. If you type where npm or which npm on Windows, you'll see the path to your npm binary. Navigate to the directory and under node modules select model context protocol, then select Puppeteer. You should see the index.js file in the dist folder. Shift right click to copy the path to the file or copy the path from Explorer. In the MCP configuration, use node as the command and the absolute path to the index.js file as the argument. If we save the file, we see that the error is resolved and the server immediately comes online. Let's test it with Gemini 2 Flash and the Aider benchmark web page. Let's tell it to browse the URL and add a standings column. It's asking for permissions to call the Puppeteer MCP tool we added. Let's tell Roo to automatically execute MCP tools. MCP tools also need permissions to execute specific functions in a particular tool. This is a security measure to verify that it executes only safe functions. It's done. Let's tell it to save the results in an HTML file. Great. We have our data nicely formatted in a table and is accurate. Our first large language model to be tested is Gemini 2 Flash. It has a 1 million context window and is very fast. We added the Brave Search MCP tool alongside the Puppeteer tool, so models can both search and scrape data from websites. Gemini models are lousy coders, so it would do them good if they can do well in agentic work. You can't be both bad at coding and bad at being a bad example. Gemini is a good example of a bad AI coder. We also asked the models to create a JSON file with all the required data so it can be used in other agentic workflows. In this configuration, you'll see that Puppeteer opens up a browser and browses the internet automatically. You can also use a headless version, although I'd advise to enable the visible browser for debug purposes. Okay, Gemini 2 Flash is done. Let's see how the output of its research looks. At first glance, this looked very, very impressive. The pricing mostly looks accurate. It added most of the requested data, added a link to the pricing page of each language model, and retrieved the Ader completion percentage. One thing it missed is the Live Bench Arena data. Sonnet pricing is correct. O1 is correct, but GPT-4o is incorrect. Gemini 2 Flash is correct, and it got O3 Mini correct as well. Next, let's see if the king of coding for language models is a good agent. Claude 3.5 Sonnet supports computer use, so let's enable it. Surprisingly, in my other tests, it didn't seem to understand instructions to prefer using MCP tools than using computer use. Puppeteer is free, and computer use isn't. We allowed it to use its native tool to get the best results from it. It says it's finished, which is suspiciously quick. If we check the research output, we see that the data is wrong. The pricing isn't for 1 million tokens, and is still incorrect, even if it was converted. It also ignored Live Bench benchmarks, like Gemini 2 Flash did. This is a very surprising discovery. Next is the language model of the season award winner, DeepSeek R1. We'll use Hyperbolic as the API provider so we get acceptable speeds. Grok and Sambanova are way faster, but unsurprisingly are much more expensive. The token counting of RooCode is definitely broken for R1, because it already says millions of tokens are sent already. R1 is asking us a clarifying question in a context where none is required. This is truly disappointing since it should have reasoned it out. It wants us to provide direct links to the pricing pages of the different providers, the very task that we told it to do. Let's tell it not to copy our homework, but to research on its own. It created the JSON file and is now creating the HTML file. It's done. Let's see how it looks. This is very disappointing for such a good model. It's missing data, and most of the data is incorrect. But I guess if we think about it using our own chain of thought, we understand that it's not what it's made for. That's why I found out that I can provide value to you by making such comparison videos, so you know which models are good at which tasks. That's a fail for R1, and Gemini 2, which is still in the sole lead. The next contender is the infamous Gemini 2 Flash thinking. Unfortunately, following the genes of the Gemini models, it's also not good at coding, as is just average in terms of reasoning. Let's see how it will perform with agentic work. Please don't mistake me speeding up the generation for the model's speed. On the bottom right, I show that I increased the speed of the video 20 times so as to save you time. For channel members and channel tip donors, please let me know which videos you want the full raw footage or behind the scenes for. It's done, but just output the HTML. Let's see how it looks. Okay, very, very impressive at first glance. Gemini 2 Flash pricing is correct. We don't have Gemini 2 Pro pricing yet, so it seems to have used the pricing for Flash. The other pricing also looks correct. This is the first model to add the live bench data, and it's accurate. So here's the final leaderboard, and Gemini models are by far the best agent language models. I'm on the right tier, but still haven't received my O3 mini access. I'll create a comparison video once I receive it. Thank you to all members, donors, and subscribers. Please smash the subscribe button for more cutting-edge comparisons. I'll see you in the next one, and hopefully the now-released Grok 3 will grant us API access, so we test it. We'll also wait for GPT 4.5 as it's around the corner. Bye.